Hello, I'm Darin Crapo, and welcome to this edition of UFO Planet. On today's program, we have some never-before-seen-on-YouTube footage of an alien peering into a window. We'll be back in 30 seconds to get that started. Well, thank you for tuning in to today's program. My mouth is completely frozen from the dentist, but you know what they say, the show must go on, so we're going to give her a shot. Our first clip tonight comes from Olympia, Washington, and this is an alien that was peering into a window. The home renter was awoken at about 2 o'clock in the morning and went to look out the window of her door because the reason they awoke was because they heard the rattling of the door. So they go look out, and what do they see looking back at them but an alien peering back at them? Let's have a look at this clip. There was about 50 photographs taken with a cell phone. The person describes the creature as reptilian that had eyes similar to gray alien. Everyone talks about had scales on its head and shoulders, bony spike shape over his skull. And all the person saw were three fingers, approximately 7 foot tall, looked strong, and stared directly into the person's eyes. As soon as the person made contact with the alien creature, apparently the alien ran off. So she said that the creature tended to appear as an image in the glass. Here's another angle of that. This person only moved to the acreage about 3 days before. It's a rental. That would probably make most people want to move back to the city because this is in the rural part of Olympia, Washington. Very interesting that was shot just a few days ago. Next, we're going to move to a clip from Cincinnati, Ohio. And in this clip, it's a time-lapse clip. This is also never before seen on YouTube. It's a time-lapse clip of a webcam from a television station that caught some information in the sky. Here's what the submitter says. A friend of mine that lives with me likes to browse webcams and found these pics. I had him send me a few because they were interesting. Whatever this thing is, it seems to be moving away from the camera in a southwest direction. Well, I'm afraid this one's kind of easy to debunk. This is simply the sun setting. The black dot that you see there that is now white in the reverse filter is just simply what the intense brightness of where the sun is, what it's doing to the pick of the camera. So that's not actually a UFO, but it could easily be confused for one. And I just want to mention as well, some people are saying, why do you have fake UFOs on your show? Well, quite frankly, not a single UFO that you see on UFO Planet has been proven scientifically. Number two, it's kind of like troubleshooting. I was a technician for many, many years. And in order to troubleshoot properly, you have to eliminate things. And it's the same thing with ufology. In order to discover the real, you're going to have to eliminate the fakes. And people need to know what to look for. So that's why we show them here on UFO Planet. So now we're going to go to Spain. And this was recorded by someone on vacation in July of 1999, but it was just recently put on the internet. And the person saw, well, listen.
Is it?
Yeah. It goes blurred and you get near it.
Buttons.
I can't. Yeah, don't seem like there's the building. There. And there's that thing there. sorry, that's a UFO.
There we go with digital zoom and filters applied.
Have you got inside the
very interesting. Culp, Spain, March 13, 2013.
Oh, yeah.
Is it right up there?
Yeah. It goes, son.
That's maximum. It goes right blurry when you get close, though, doesn't it?
Fantastic clip recorded in Spain. Now, unfortunately, the tourists were about to go out for dinner, and on YouTube, the videographer explains that after about 10 minutes of recording, family members were starting to get anxious to go for dinner, so he had to quit filming. I think I would have foregone dinner. That's just my opinion, though. Next, we're going to take a look at some orbs over Australia. Interesting, because the person went to film this, it was in a triangle formation. He thought it was a triangular UFO, but then look and see what happens. So there you see the orbs in a triangular formation, but then that triangle begins to break up and disappear. Absolutely fascinating. 2013 in Australia, uploaded March 13, 2013 to the particular channel that our research team found this on. Orbs over Australia. We see this formation a lot, but you never really think of it as being three individual crafts. A lot of people think that the triangular formations are one craft, but I would like to know personally what the triangle means. It obviously has some significance if more than one craft form. And you notice that the sides of a pyramid and all that sort of thing, they form a triangle. There must be some significance there. Excellent shot. You can see the city line. And of course, we have our digital reverse image in the top right hand corner, so you can see what it looks like reversed. Very interesting. That's over Australia. Well, thanks everyone who sends comments to UFO Planet, and here's what some of you said on the last episode. Rob in the UK, I think you're 100%. We're definitely seeing something. There's more to the story than meets the eye. Next, speaking of stories that meets the eye, we're going to take a look at some clouds forming. Now, this particular cloud formation, and you'll see how quickly it happens. In this very same spot the day before, the person who shot the clouds also captured video, witnessed a UFO in the same spot. The next day he takes out his camera to see if it might return, and have a look and see what he captured then.
Never told me. There you go. There's no clouds in the sky whatsoever. It's all vague. That's funny. Look, David.
Take a look at these David, clouds look. Right in the center of your screen. Watch them form and look. Watch the clock.
You see it? You see them? They just materializing. Awesome. I mean, they just growing. Look, David. Look.
Intense. They're how fast bigger. Those clouds
look,
are forming.
It's getting bigger. Look.
There was some speculation online that the UFO was cloaking itself by forming a cloud around it as it went through a dimension.
You know, that's how
now, I just superimposed there on the screen what those clouds look like, reverse image, so we could see if there's anything hiding in there. And I examined it close up. I could not see anything in there, that resembled a craft per se, but it was it could very well be hidden behind the clouds, making it appear as though it's not there. I've never seen clouds form that fast. I found that very fascinating. This was recorded April 13, 2008, but not uploaded to the internet until just a little bit of here ago on March 11, 2013. Fascinating. I've seen clouds moving fast and storm clouds, and I've seen funnel clouds and things like that, but I've never seen a cloud in a cloudless sky just form very quickly like that. Next, we're going to take a look at a clip that was sent to us by one of our followers in Russia, and we'd like to say hello to all of the UFO followers in Russia, and there are several of you. Appreciate you watching the show very much, and thank you so much for sending along your clips. We received several. We're going to play one right now, and this is of colorful lights recorded over Moscow. UFO 71, who is our follower, he uploaded this to the internet on August 6, 2012. It hasn't had a lot of views, but I did find it quite interesting. Certainly not easy to explain. Some very bright lights up in the sky. I run it through a few filters here, and look how it has multiple colors to it and appears to be like it is maneuvering or rotating of some sort. I don't think that's one of those lead kites. It doesn't look like a lead kite to me, although there is a lot of color involved there. Very colorful lights. I certainly have no explanation for that. And it's hard to say what it is. Now there's a digital enhanced stop motion digital zoom of the colored lights. It almost looks like a cloud that's illuminated. Now that we take a look at it in reverse image, see there's some very bright colorful lights in the middle of that object. Very interesting. Next clip, we're gonna move on to Kansas City, Missouri. And there was unfortunately no information with this clip, but it's very interesting to look at. And see it right there in the middle of your screen. We also have the reverse image in the top right-hand corner. Almost looks like a ball that's floating up in the sky. There was a little bit of chatter in the background here, but it was basically just the videographer telling the date. If you're shooting a video, also the videographer mentioned, sorry for the jitteriness, that she was holding the tripod in her hand. Great move to have a tripod, but put it on the ground. Getting it 2 feet closer isn't going to make a whole lot of difference. But that is a fascinating video, digital zoom, slow motion there. Uploaded on March 16th, so just a couple of days ago, shot in Kansas City, Missouri on March 15th. 2013. Fascinating clip. Well done, Planet Nuvo on YouTube. There is a lot of movement there, but the videographer did admit that she was holding her tripod in her hand, and that certainly would have made a difference there. Well, that looks like just about all the time. A couple of clips that we actually didn't have time to play on today's program. So we'll catch those on the next episode. And as a matter of fact, you can go to our website and click on the program schedule, click on the program dates in the calendar, and you'll see what clips we have scheduled to come up in the next program. And we add each clip to the program schedule as we create it. And that's on our website. You can go to it at 4u2ctv.com. And if you'd like to submit your video, go ahead and do that too. Thanks for watching. See you again next time.